Dave, I want to try to discern the relationship between your views of reality, potential reality, and the nature of mathematics. So you have various views that you've enjoyed speculating about. They are extreme views, but as we all recognize, we need extreme views in terms of understanding consciousness. And so let me pose two, maybe three. I mean, panpsychism, idealism, and that we're living in a simulation. All three are radically different. I think maybe one could you could have a number of combinations, but those are three radically different ways of looking at fundamental reality. So in each case, what would be the role of mathematics in each of those three cases?
Well, maybe we can comment this by thinking about the old idea that reality is itself a kind of mathematical structure. This goes back to the ancient philosopher Pythagoras, of Pythagoras's theorem, who basically thought that numbers are the fundamental entities in the universe, and the universe was basically a universe of mathematics. These days, this view is attracting some following. Again, it looks like the laws of physics seem to be fundamentally mathematical. Our best descriptions of reality seem to be in terms of mathematical equations. So it becomes attractive to say the universe is fundamentally mathematical. So at some level, that can't be everything there is to the story. If the universe was just a mathematical structure, every mathematical structure exists, every world exists, science would seem kind of pointless. How is it leading us to one rather than the others? So there has to be something that's somehow more concrete than that. Something, if you like, that puts the fire into the equations. And maybe this is a place where consciousness has a role. The other place where consciousness has a role is it seems like consciousness is one thing which is not just mathematics. Maybe we can make sense of the structures out there in the physical world in terms of math. But my consciousness, you know, the reds, the greens, the emotions, the qualities, we can mathematize them, but they seem to have some intrinsic qualities that aren't just mathematics. So that kind of leads to a view where, yes, reality has a mathematical structure that runs very deep, but there has to be something sort of underneath that structure that puts the fire into the equations, consciousness. That can lead one to the panpsychist view of reality. We need something that all this mathematical structure is structure between. We need some mathematics tells us how all these fundamental entities relate to each other. But then the question is, what are they in themselves? They need some non-mathematical nature, and a speculation is that that might be consciousness.
One could speculate the other direction as well and say that consciousness ultimately is some sort of an informational system that processes information, and that information is fundamental, and information then is dependent upon a mathematical structure. And so ultimately it's the math to information to consciousness.
Yeah, so a kind of another approach which doesn't give consciousness as central a role is the idea of the it from bit universe. That at the fundamental level, there are just bits of information, and then there are laws that process them, and ultimately these bits give rise to the physical world that maybe gives rise to consciousness. That, in a sense, is a relative of the idea that the world is just mathematics. But I guess the world is not pure mathematics on this view. The world is, if you like, applied mathematics. The bits still need to be put into motion.
Right.
There's got to be some set of fundamental equations, which are the equations of reality. Somehow, some bits of mathematics got selected as the ones that govern our world. And I find that it from bit view very attractive, at least as a view of the physical world, although how it accommodates the human mind, it's harder for me to see.
I think a simulated world is the easiest to explain, because simulation would just mean that we're not the ultimate reality, and the simulation is information, and information is mathematical. So that would seem to be almost a trivial. So if we are a simulation, then that is some sort of a mathematical structure, but it says nothing about ultimate reality.
Yeah, I've been very interested in this idea of the universe as a simulation. And I've argued there's actually a very close connection between that and the informational idea of it from bit. The rough idea is, just say we are in a simulation. I don't rule it out, who's to know? Just say we are in a simulation, then there is a sense in which bits ones and zeros underlie ordinary physical reality. Reality underneath this body, underneath this chair, is some physics. Underneath the physics is some bits. Now, if we're in a simulation, though, there's a caveat to that. The bits themselves aren't fundamental. Right. They're running on a computer in the next universe up. Right. So it's going to go from us to bits to a computer in the next universe up.
And who knows,
and then who knows what's under that? Right. More bits, more computers, more levels of reality.
But if we are a simulation, that undercuts your whole idea that consciousness is fundamental in this world. Isn't that, wouldn't that be the case?
Well, I think it leaves open all the same possibilities, but they're going to arise at the fundamental level.
Oh, right, right. But I'm saying in this world. In this world, if we are a simulation, then consciousness in this world is not fundamental. I have no idea what the higher worlds are.
Well, I take the simulation idea to fundamentally be an idea about the physical world. So it does certainly mean that our bodies are not fundamental.
Right.
And there are processes and information underneath the physical world. What's going on with consciousness is a whole different question.
So consciousness may be this flow between all worlds.
Maybe somehow all that information. I think consciousness is connected to information. I think there are fundamental principles that say when you've got certain kinds of information processing, you get consciousness. But maybe that information processing could be going on at the fundamental level. Maybe it could be going on at a higher level. But still, in my view, there'll be fundamental principles connecting that to consciousness. So,
the most interesting one to me is idealism, because idealism posits that at its fundamental level is a kind of mind or consciousness or some generalized approach to that. And that is fundamental, and then somehow the physical world is derived from that in some way. So in that case, assume that to be the case, what is the role of mathematics? Because if consciousness, which is non-mathematical, potentially, that would make mathematical non-fundamental if we have a pure idealism as fundamental reality.
It's an interesting question whether idealism explains, say, the physical world in terms of the mind. Does it also explain mathematics in terms of the mind? A very strong form of idealism says, yeah, mathematics too is all in the mind. I have to say that even though I've got sympathy for idealism, I find that view very hard to stomach. The idea that 2 + 2 = 4 somehow derives from someone's consciousness. Yeah. As an ex-mathematician, I think mathematics is just more fundamental and more universal than that. It didn't depend on my mind or on anyone's mind, the 2 + 2 = 4. Maybe idealism could be true to the extent that, you know, the theory of relativity or the theory of evolution even arise from connections between people's minds, but that mathematics arises from the mind. I guess I think of mathematics as objective. So I'm not, maybe that brings out that even though I've got some interest in idealism about the physical world, I'm not a full-blooded idealist. A full-blooded idealist would try to explain mathematics too in terms of the human mind.
So at least at this point, if you're going to go to idealism, you have a parallel a source of fundamental reality, which is mathematics and maybe other abstract objects, who knows, but certainly mathematics. So you're a dualist. If you're an idealist, you're a dualist idealist.
I guess that's right. We've got the abstract world, the world of mathematics. We've got the concrete world, the world of physics. And maybe I'm more sympathetic with idealism about the concrete world being grounded in the mind, but somehow the fundamental level of the physical world and and mathematics have to come together because physics is itself mathematical. So if you're an idealist, then maybe somehow the mathematics plays that role of structuring the mental structures into the laws of physics, the familiar dynamics that we get from physics. So somehow maybe on this metaphysics, mathematics and mind come together dualistically, as you say, to generate reality.